just an old man now covered with scars. And most of them I got fighting and lead band bars. And a bunch of brand new tattoos the scrubs put on me. He covered up the ones I'd gotten years ago, back in prison, when I was just Dave Coe, and I wasn't famous then, but I wasn't free. You know, I grew up in a three-room rundown shack, but fully healed by the railroad track, where decent folks don't go when the sun goes down. My daddy worked at the Goodyear Tar and Rubber Company, and he worked on cars. My mama went to church, and my daddy went to bars. And most people just call it the hillbilly part of town. I had a 55 Chevy when I was 15. I painted it red because I was steel green. I mean, hell, I couldn't even afford to buy gas. I had a 410 rifle and a Bowie knife, too. And red in the back of that I like to chew. And we count them cars when the trains went past. In the fatty country, I'll kiss your ass. Sister Diane down to the funeral home to see the old man. Jimmy was the oldest, Diane, she was the youngest one. Jack and Ray was in the middle, and then there was me. I'm the one that turned 23 and grew up to be that Yankees rebel son. Kind of changing, I heard Bob Dylan say, been 22 years now since my father passed away. I can still picture him in his overalls. Standing around the house where he made his deals. Around the porch was a bunch of old wheels and some used Harley Davidson parts that he sold for cash. They was simply holding old Kendrick. Me and my family was living through. Everybody called us old poor wife.